Hello guys, Dejan here. Welcome back to the channel. First thing that I want to say is Merry Christmas for all you guys that are celebrating, and Happy New Year. And I wish you all success, positive vibes and good health in the upcoming year. And I want to use this opportunity just to recap like what happened in this famous 2020 for me. Like as you guys probably know, this is the year when I decided that I want to start collecting, playing and painting Infinity. So it was amazing year for me in the Infinity world, since I collected a lot of models, painted a lot of different stuff. I have a lot of unassembled and unpainted stuff. I played a lot of games, and I started my own YouTube channel. Because of the lockdown and everything, I was not able to play. I was just sitting down painting. And then I decided, okay, maybe, actually it's not my decision, my girlfriend actually suggested, like, hey, maybe you should turn on camera and start recording what you're doing since you're already sitting there and painting. So I tried, and feedback from community was amazing. So I wanna say one more time, thank you so much guys for all the support that I got from the Infinity community. It is, I cannot explain with the words how much does this mean to me, and I won't disappoint you. I will keep doing this because I love Infinity, like everything about these games, like from the quality of the models, from the design of the models, how the game plays, and the community and everything. So I will keep doing it. I will just use this opportunity to show you what I did and what I achieved in 2020. So without further ado, let's start and let's see what's happening on my tabletop.
So guys, this is it. I managed to put everything on the table. As I roughly counted, it was like around 180 models from different factions. So all of it was painted this year, so it was like mix of everything. I will go slowly through each faction and try to explain what I did and how I did, just quickly. I don't wanna take much of your time, but this is it. Like it looks like a lot to me now when I look at it like this. It took me like, I think, like 45 minutes just to take everything from the shelves and arrange it on the table. So let me start quickly with Ariadna. Here I think I bought like the start collecting box for Ariadna. I think from here there's one dog warrior missing and a motorcycle. So what I decided to do with this box, because at that moment I didn't want to collect Ariadna as my faction, so I used these models just to try to show the people on the different aspects of the camo. So I painted all the models from that box in the different camos, so they look like a unit of Power Rangers now. But yeah, I find them like really nice. Then I tried to explain how to paint a model with a contrast paint. I painted this dog warrior following Angel Giralde's guide and doing some my own stuff on it. I think this is the first Ariadna model that I ever painted. Another dog warrior. It turned out like really cool with this old Scottish kilt and the stuff. Then we move to my GSA. So this is the first faction. When I saw the pictures, I was like, okay, this is the one that I'm going to collect. So it would be GSA. And then when I started playing them, it was like, ooh, they are not that easy to play. They kind of play a lot different than any other faction, and they are quite difficult to play. But anyway, like they are my love, and I'm going to treat them, and I'm going to finish this faction. I have start collecting a GSA army box, so there is I think one or two models from that box to be done. And then I think I have two more of these dudes, but I haven't received the heads from Corvus Belli when I bought it, and they sent me the replacements, but I think the replacements got lost as well because it's been 2 months and they still haven't arrived, so I'll have to text them again and see what's happening with that. But anyway, like I did like some extra motorcycles, I painted the whole box. It was more or less the same paint scheme of all the models. This was the one that I did at the start, when I was spraying them outside when it was really humid, so I kind of ruined them, so I will have maybe to strip them in the future and redo them. But at this point, there is not that much time for that. And then I managed to finish the tag and everything. All in all, a very easy faction to paint, because you paint mostly like black, white and red on all the stuff. It's very easy to highlight and all do. So I did a different version with the contrast paints, with the layering, some airbrushing. So it was a quite good practice for me to try the different paint jobs. So here we have some random Nomads models that I painted. Actually, I like the Nomads faction so much that I'm going to start to collect them and paint them. So you're going to see a lot more of these guys in the future, probably very soon. Painted Perseus, turned out like really nice. I really liked how he turned out at the end. And I had like Beyond the Ice Storm box with these two models. The third one is still on the shelf. Then I painted Jelena Kovac because she's a like ex-Yugoslavian Serbian character, and I really like the story, so I have to paint her. And then this one was for one of the Vallejo paint sets that we tried to follow and see that can we paint the model using that paint set to that box art that they displayed it on the box. So it was really nice set and I managed to actually achieve it to the acceptable level, so I was really happy how it turned on. So at the end, after that, I think I bought the old paint sets and I did all the guys, so you can find them in the channel if you're interested in how the rest of the things turned out. Then we have a few Aleph random models, some Asuras Hacker that's done, Achilles. So I did a video on him, how to paint white, Dart, the Ultimate Huntress, very nice model as well. Of course, we did the Santa for the Christmas, and what we have on this side. Yeah, the model I painted like for my games, very cheap, very good my layer. This the bounty hunter that I painted that wanted to do like some Borderlands scheme. It was very interesting video that showing my mistakes and the things how done, the learning process about doing it. The only Toha model I painted so far. I know the Toha people will kill me, but yeah, more Toha will come in the future, guys, I promise. It was just not their time at this moment, but I promise I will paint them more. I loved the idea behind these models and behind the faction, so I will paint more of them for sure. The other thing that I didn't paint it that much, but I would love to paint them a lot more, is the O12 and the Starmada. I only painted these three models. This one I painted only using the contrast paints, just to try to do some quick job for the people who wanted just to put the models on the table without thinking that much about details. So they turn out quite nicely. And then this one I painted with a paint set that came with. It was my first ever try of painting non-metallic metal. And I don't know, it turned out really decent, but when I compare it, like, because this took I think 4, 5, 6 hours to complete, and this took like maybe 2, I was like, I would prefer doing this way, like if I want a quick army, but if I manage to level up and practice these skills here to manage to do this model on this level much faster, I would going to do it this way. And now we are coming to my, let's say, main four factions, which I play most of the games with. So let me start... let me start from the Combined Army. I start collecting them when they released the Operation Karlstrom and the Code 1. So there is not that much models. As you can see, there is a start collecting box. I think there's 10 models from there. Code Ali was an extra model purchased. And there is one of the Nox Warriors, I think this one was the one that I painted with the paint set that came with, which I was amazed how well it turned. I was like surprised myself. I was like, ooh, I can do this. Like, it was good. And I bought a Dr. Worm. There is a Speculo Killer extra. And there is two Zeodrom Betroids, which I picked up after. So after that, the Sphinx was revealed. I think I have her somewhere here on the table as well. She's ready to be painted. I just need to find some more time and sit paint them. I mean, everything depends on my work, because I have a full-time job which requires a lot of traveling. So imagine one month time I usually have to travel around the whole globe. So sometimes I'm away from home for even 2 weeks. So we will see how we'll be. Depends everything about the lockdowns and the stuff, but I will keep doing the videos. You can expect it more or less in the same pace coming out as they're coming by now, like 2 times per week. We will see how the things will go with the Combined Army. I love it. I will add more stuff. Maybe I will try with the other sectorials and see how it will go. But so far I play I think maybe 3 or 4 games with them, a few win the Code 1 and a few win the Infinity M4, and I really liked how they play, and I really enjoy them. I like the style. I like this combination of the alien and predators and this stuff. It's really cool. And now we can move to the Yuching. So this is the first army that I start collecting when I decided to start playing Infinity. So as you can see, everything is mixed, all the bases are different, there is so many random models. I think first I pick up Operation Ice Storm. It was not the Ice Storm, it was the other one, the Red Veil, Operation Red Veil, yes. So I bought that one, and I painted some models, because that one was the Yuching versus Hakislam, yeah. And then after that, I just pick up, without knowing that you cannot combine some sectorials with the vanilla. At that time I didn't have a clue, so I bought some Imperial Service starter. As you can see here, I was experimenting with the different shades of the orange armor, of the yellow armor. It was still going here and there. I didn't know which colors to use, how to paint them. It was all one learning process. By the end, when the Operation Karlstrom came out, I was settled with my paint scheme, I was settled with my paints, so I was already okay, this is how I'm going to do it. So I managed to do the whole Operation Karlstrom, and I think the whole all the models that came after. I actually didn't paint all of them. I think they still have 3 or 4 models there on the table that are just in different states of painting process, but they're going to be done pretty soon. Because I'm planning to start promoting the game in my local game store, so I want everything to be tip-top before we start, which should be happen, I think, somewhere in the early in the January. Oh, I played a lot of games with the Yuching. I played some games with the White Company, mixing both Yuching and Pano, and I was really happy with them. I like how they play. Like all those like camo tokens. All my models have like 2 wounds or more. We all have good weapons, and we will just go there and kill the stuff. It's pretty cool, like to play with them. And then we come to the Haki Slam. This was Operation Red Whale, plus there were some models from... I forgot which starter set these guys came out. And then I bought Saladin and Tariq Masur. We have this girl, she's from Aristea, but I don't like her because she's plastic. And I'm not a big fan of plastic models. I'm like, I prefer metal ones. This is my first army that I started painting Infinity. As you can see, the paint job, it's nothing impressive. So this is just the contrast paints and nothing else. So few highlights here and there. So yeah, I think maybe I can show you like later when I finish with this evolution of my painting in this year, like how I came like from painting model like this, and how does one that I recently finished look like. Maybe you can see the difference. Did I improve, or did my skill didn't change at all? Yeah, I didn't play Haki Slam that much. I was playing it during the Operation Red Whale in the entry while still learning the Infinity rules. So I was playing it with a few friends, so it was all like playing the games without knowing half of the rules, making so many mistakes, but it was super fun. Like I like them, I like how they play, and I will see, they're not now my number one army to be expanded in the future, but for sure I'm going to paint some Haki Slam stuff for the channel. And I think that will naturally evolve and expand this little arc. And at the end, we are coming to the Panoseani army. This was my, let's say, second army that, yeah, it is a second army that I start expanding. But actually it turned up at the end the army that I played the most, that I'm still keep playing it in the different versions of it. And I really like them, I don't know why. Like, I like those MSVs, I like my RO pieces that I just stand there, like a Karhu, Panzerfast and other stuff in the Link team, and just holding the lanes. It's really cool stuff. So yeah, this will be the army that's going to be expanded 100%. I will be keep adding the models to it, and we'll see how it will go. So all the special characters are painted. I have the box of Aristea, everything is painted there, but as I said, they're not my favorites because they are plastic. I don't like painting plastic. And they're one of the first models I painted, actually, from Corvus Belli. If I manage to find all of these in metal, that would be amazing. I will paint them for sure. So guys, here are the some models that I painted. Like, this is one of the first models that I painted from for the Infinity. And then after that, where is that? This one. Painted only the contrast paints, and then this one of the last ones that I painted, the Joan of Arc, and this guy, the Nox Trooper, and of course the tags, the two tags that I painted that I really like how they turn out. Yeah, only thing is like the Blue Wolf, you are too small. I was expecting him to be much bigger. I don't know why, like I had the perception that it is a bigger tag, and then when I opened the box and I assembled him, I was like, oh, he's not that big, like as a cutter, because cutter is like almost double its size. But yeah, I like how both of these models turn out at the end. So happy. That's it, I think. I hope you like this little review of my 2020 year. So this is all painted this year. Like, I'm not sure, maybe one model was painted like at the end of the last year, but most of the Infinity stuff is painted this year. And you can find for most of this stuff videos on my YouTube channel. I think I have around 90 videos which cover like most of this stuff. And what is not covered now, it will be probably covered in the future with some new videos explaining some stuff, maybe repainting some other models. I mean, I have so many ideas. I mean, if you can see, I will show you now how my pile of the stuff to be done looks like. Maybe I won't show you, actually. I don't wanna spoil you the things for the future, but there is like a big queue of the stuff that is already ready to be painted in the next year. And guys, so tell me, what is your favorite faction and which was your favorite model of the last year? For me specifically, my number one model was the Blue Wolf. I think this is the 2020 model that came out from the Corvus Belli, the best one. So just let me know, like, do you have a different opinion or you have any different model that you like? And as well, if you'd like to see me painting something specifically, just give me a shout out in the comment section down below, and I will do my best. And guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. It will mean a lot to me. And if you have any comments and suggestions, please let me know in the comment section down below and I will do my best to reply. And guys, this is all for now. See you in 2021. And take care. Be healthy. Stay safe. And see you soon. Bye bye.